The Joe Rogan Experience.
For sure, in boxing, too.
Yeah.
You know, in boxing, it used to be thought that you pretty much, you know, if you went to a good trainer, they would teach you to keep your hands up. That was always the way to box. But then you get to a level of like a Tommy Hearns. Remember the way Tommy Hearns used to fight? He used to keep his left hand low, really low.
Yeah, down at
his
side.
His right hand cocked. Mm-hmm. And he would snap that left hand at you like a fucking, like a cobra, man. Just crack. Motor City Cobra. He would just pop that fucker right in your face. That's why they used to call him that.
Because it was coming out of
the
fucking
Detroit
nowhere.
Detroit hitman. Tommy Hearns. He was a bad motherfucker, dude. And then, bang, he would hit you with that right hand. And he had so much torque because he was really wide.
Yeah.
He was really long and wide for a welterweight, man. Like, you'd look at him at 147 pounds. I think he was probably like 6'2". And just shredded.
Jacked.
And just cracking
147?
People.
At 6'2"
he was
is
welterweight
like...
champ. You ever see what he looked like when he fought Sugar Ray Leonard?
Uh-uh.
Oh, my God. Yeah, and then he went up to 160 and fought Hagler and got KO'd by Hagler in a crazy slugfest. You never saw that fight? Pull up Marvin Hagler versus Thomas Hearns. This might have been the great, I think it went two rounds, but it might have been the greatest two rounds in the history of the middleweight division because these two guys were super skilled. I mean, Marvin Hagler was a brilliant technical boxer, can switch from southpaw to orthodox, like fluidly. Like right. you didn't even notice a difference. He fought just as good from both sides, and he knocked everybody out, and he had an iron chin. And Tommy Hearns was murking motherfuckers. He murked Roberto Duran with one punch, just blah, blah, face planted
one
him.
One fucking hit.
One punch, man. He stung him with one shot, and let him see that first. Here's the buildup. The buildup is Tommy Hearns KOs Roberto Duran. Let's watch that first. And then we're going to go back to Marvin Hagler versus Tommy Hearns. So you get a feel for what it was like.
To be able to switch up your stances is so crazy to me, to be able to do that so fluidly.
Well, that's one of the brilliant things about Hagler. I mean, he was just so good at that. And he could buy. And it's weird for a guy. When you're used to, I remember the first time I fought a guy who was left-handed, it was super confusing. Everything's coming from the wrong place. Everything was like reversed. You got to get used to it.
Right.
You don't see it as often, right? So if you don't see it as often, sometimes it's more effective. But some guys are really good against southpaw. Some guys have like a lightning right hand. And that was one of the speculations about Hagler and Hearns, because Hearns had this lightning right hand, and Hagler oftentimes fought southpaw. And that's the counter for southpaw, is a straight right. Now watch this, though. This goes to show you how, God, look how big he is. Bang! Dude! Dude,
Jesus
play
Christ.
That again. Look at this. Boom! Come on, man. When Tommy Hearns murked Jesus people, Christ. He murked people. And you got to understand, man, he did this to Roberto Duran.
That's fast in slow motion.
Dude, he was so fast.
That looks fast even in fucking slow motion.
He was so fast, and he hit so hard. But now you got to watch this. And this is Hagler in his prime. He was 30 years old. He was the undisputed motherfucking middleweight champion of the world, and most people thought he was the best pound-for-pound fighter on earth. And Tommy Hearns, of course, you just saw what he did to Roberto Duran.
Yeah.
And there was a lot of speculation coming into this fight. And they just went at it from the beginning of the round. There was very little feel-ups, just constant pressure by Hagler, right hooks, boom, boom. I mean, look at this, bro. They're going Jesus to Christ. War. These are two of the best fucking middleweights ever. And they're standing in front of each other going to war.
And it doesn't feel like anybody's phased. It feels like they're at the exact same energy level too.
Oh, dude!
Like both of them have the same output. Look at those fucking hooks.
This is crazy fight, man. And they were throwing full power shots from the moment the fight started.
Jesus!
And they're right in front of each other, man. And for Hearns, this negates his gigantic reach advantage over almost everybody.
Yeah.
So Hearns decided to fight this way. He decided to stand right. Look at him. The referee could barely separate him. Hearns decided to stand right in front of Hagler, and Hagler decided to stand right in front of Hearns. And now Hearns is moving. See, now this is what Hearns could have done from the beginning and made it interesting.
Sticking and moving.
But by the time he decided to do that, he was already touched up. And Marvin starts moving in for the kill, that left hand to the body. And Hagler was relentless, and his cardio was fucking supreme. It was supreme. He always put pressure on people, and you couldn't hurt him. He only had one bullshit knockdown his entire career. It was a bullshit knockdown. He fought, I think it was Juan Roldan, and Juan Roldan kind of like, it was more like a shove, and maybe they tripped or something like that, and the referee called it a knockdown. But God. I remember thinking, God damn it. Because Hagler had a weird thing that he was either born with or developed. He had giant muscles on the side of his head, Like he was born with headgear. I'm not bullshitting. They had him analyzed.
With a helmet on?
This was like a big thing in the world of sports back in the day. Like that he was literally almost born for this. That's how good Hagler was.
Yeah, these motherfuckers are I mean, it's relentless, dude. They're towed up every time. It's they're barely looking for any distance between each other.
And you got to realize, man, this is not how people usually fight. They don't throw full power shots with every shot.
I mean, they'd be tired within 15 seconds. These guys are just going at it.
So I think this was like almost like a game of chicken. Like both of them knew they were never going to reach the 12th round.
Right.
So they said, fuck it. Let's just do this. And Hagler just stood right in front of him, constantly blasting him. And you see, at the end of the first round, Hearns is wilting. He just does not have the power or the speed or the movement. See, he's all goofy.
Yeah, he's sloppy.
Like, yeah.
It's
well,
getting
he's
real
just
sloppy.
Exhausted. He's exhausted. But still, the warrior in him is making him throw these fucking bombs, man. You got to realize, like, at the time, no one really knew what the fuck was going to happen in this fight. And then Hagler heard him.
Yeah. There's a little stumble.
And one of Hagler's incredible attributes besides his skill was his determination to win, man. He was just, he was a ferocious competitor, man. Just ferocious. And so if someone was willing to engage him in this kind of crazy fight, where you're going to stand toe-to-toe and see who's the bigger man, oh my God, everyone's going to die. Hagler's going to take you to the end of the earth, man. To the end of the earth.
I mean, Hagler just looked like he just had still so much left in the tank, even at the end of the first round. Like,
dude,
it was
he could
nothing.
Do this for years. He's never out of shape. He never partied. He never did anything stupid.
What? He didn't have any short. No?
Never got fat.
No drugs, no alcohol, nothing?
Nope. And how about this? Retired after the Sugar Ray Leonard fight. Lost a controversial decision to Sugar Ray Leonard that to this day, I think he won. And then, but it was a close fight.
Yeah.
But, and then just retired and became a fucking movie star in Italy.
That's fucking wild.
Love that guy.
Yeah, but that's the way to do it, huh? Kind of go out at a good prime and then just say goodnight.
Yeah, nobody else did it like him, man. Yeah. Nobody else did it like him. Oof. Ooh, that's when he hurt him.
Yep.
Now he's just moving in for the kill. Moving in for the kill. Now he's taking his time. Look. Yeah. So now it's just nice and relaxed. This is inevitable now. Marvin's just moving in and deciding when he's going to uncork, moving in, blocking these shots. He knows that Hearns is hurt, and he starts teeing him up. Boom.
God damn.
Right Chin. Hand. And Hearns is trying to move now. See, now that's how I thought Hearns was going to fight, and most people thought Hearns was going to fight from the beginning, like that.
Just
from
keep
the
moving,
outside,
moving,
from the
moving.
Outside. Yeah. Sting him from the outside like that. I mean, that's classic Thomas Hearns. But the warrior in him wanted to find out, you know? He wanted to find out. Who's the baddest motherfucker in town? Who is it? You know?
You could you can feel him backing up kind of. He knows what's kind of. It's almost like he knows what's coming. He's getting in some good shots, even then he's creating distance, but even still, it just doesn't feel like he's balanced.
I mean, Hagler is standing
right
in front
there.
Of him. He's hurting him now. Hagler's standing right in front of him. I mean, he is touching him, but he just doesn't have the pop anymore. You know what it's like when you're working out, and at the end of the workout, you're fucking exhausted, and you can barely do one rep.
Yep.
That's what happens with your arms when you're fighting.
There's nothing left in
them. There's nothing left. It's not like, he's doing this on purpose.
Right.
He doesn't have, there's no gas in his arms. Like his arms are completely flooded right now. Like all the blood in them and everything. It's just, they're not recovering. It's a horrible feeling too. He's swinging though. Look, he's swinging, but it's way slower than it was in the first round.
Right. His snap was so much quicker in the first round. Yeah. Now he's not following through a little bit.
He's trying to conserve energy.
Right.
He realizes he can't do this forever. He's exhausted.
God, they both look like they're fucking at that little breaking point where it's about to be either.
I'm telling you, Hagler, even though it might look like that because it is a fast pace, he could do this for years.
Jesus.
He could do this for years. He just didn't get tired, man. And you couldn't hurt him. It was crazy. He fought a dude named John the Beast Mugabe. And John the Beast Mugabe was fucking terrifying people, man. He starched Terry Norris. He starched a bunch of dudes. He was a heavy puncher. Heavy puncher. And Hagler stood right in front of him. And he got caught with one big uppercut and he didn't even budge. Uppercuts that were like murking people.
He didn't even flinch.
So what round was it? Is it the third round?
It's the beginning of the third, yes.
The third round.
Here's the third round
here. This just shows you how fucking tough Tommy Hearns was.
I mean, those two rounds were just fucking knockdown, drag out.
Relentless.
Yeah, just nonstop.
But towards the end, you clearly see Hagler's coming on. I mean, he looks good. He looks good, and he's pacing himself now. He's just moving forward, throwing shots. But yeah, Hearns is exhausted, man. It's fucking rough, man. There it is. Boom.
Boom.
Boom. Hearns is trying to keep him off.
Yeah, he's trying to keep him. Right.
But he's having a hard time breathing, though, man. I mean, he's exhausted. See that? Big, deep breath.
When you take that big sigh, it's almost like, nah.
Somebody lost a mouthpiece, I think.
Is that what it was? He called his time?
Yeah, I think that's what happened. I don't know, man. It's hard to tell. It's really blurry footage.
I was just going
to
say, man, 240p was weird back then, huh? It looked normal to us back then. Dude, eyes knew how to handle it, right?
Well, you were just excited that you could see the fight.
Right.
You know? But this wasn't. I wonder if this would have looked like when it was on HBO.
Had to have been.
It looked a little better on those TVs.
Do you know HBO just canceled boxing? They don't have boxing anymore?
At all. Just pay-per-view now?
They don't even do pay-per-view. They're out of the boxing business.
What?
Yeah. Isn't that crazy?
So they'll never...
Here it is. That right hand?
Oh, and he's moving.
Boom, right hand. Boom.
Oh, it's done.
That's it.
He knew it.
Damn.
That's it.
Third round.
Gone.
I always miss this. I always think it's the second round for some reason. I think we've actually gone over this before.
But third round.
Yeah, man. But they don't have boxing anymore. HBO's got out of the boxing business.
What do you think that's because of? It's not earning enough money anymore?
I don't know. It makes me sad, though. They had some of the greatest boxing telecasts of all time. I mean, that was what you would do. You'd go, if a big fight was on, Bernard Hopkins was on, a lot of the times it was on HBO.
Yeah.
And if it was on pay-per-view, then you knew it was going to be on HBO the following week.
Right.
So even if you couldn't afford the pay-per-view,
you could see
hang in there a week later. You knew who won, but you could watch the fight on HBO.